To download Windows 11 ISO file, open internet browser and from your favorite search engine, search for Windows 11 ISO download. From the list, select the link from Microsoft Software Download link. On the open page, scroll down to download Windows 11 disk image ISO. From the drop-down, select Windows 11 and click Download. Select your language and click Confirm. Lastly, click on 64-bit download to start the download. Open VMware Workstation Pro and from the homepage, click on Create a New Virtual Machine. On the Open Wizard, select Custom and hit Next. On the Compatibility page, select the highest hardware compatibility available and click Next. This setting is only important to you if you want to copy or move your VM to another computer using another version of VMware. This identifies the minimum version of VMware Workstation that can open this virtual machine. On the next page, select I will install the operating system later and click Next. Under Guest Operating System, select Microsoft Windows and from the drop-down, select Windows 10 and later x64, then click Next. On the next page, give your VM a name and select the location where the VM is installed. In my case, VM is installed in D drive and virtualization folder. Make a note of your VM location. You will need to change a file in that location later in this video. Click Next. On Firmware Type page, select UEFI and hit Next. On the next page, select the number of CPUs and cores per CPU to assign to your virtual machine, then hit Next. For my demo, I select two processors with two cores for each. On the next page, select how much memory would you like to assign to your VM. I select 4 gigs, as this is the minimum recommended amount by Microsoft. If you need, you can reduce it after the installation is finished. On the next page, select your VM's network connectivity. Select Host Only and click Next. By selecting Host Only, your VM will not have access to the internet. You can change the network settings after the installation is finished. If you select NAT or Breached, your VM would have access to internet during the setup and will force you to use Microsoft account. You will not be able to create a local user and you would not be able to log in without a Microsoft account. Although there are solutions to bypass that limitation, but it is faster and easier to block internet access during the setup and change the network setting later. If you need to learn how to create a Microsoft account, click the link on top of your screen to watch that video. If you would like, you can still use Microsoft account after the installation is finished. On the next page, VMware will ask you about the controller types for the hard drive. Select the recommended option and click Next. In my case, LSI Logic SAS is recommended. Next page, select the disk type and click Next. Depending on your computer's hardware, the options might be different. Select the recommended option and click Next. Select Create a new virtual disk and hit Next. On the next page, select your virtual machine hard disk size. I use the recommended 60 gig. It is best to leave Allocate all disk space now checkmark unchecked. If you select this option, Windows will allocate the complete identified space immediately. By leaving it unchecked, Windows will create a virtual disk with the minimum size that will start to grow as you put data in it. I will have more detailed videos about disks, virtual disks, and dynamically expanding disks in the future. Optionally, you can decide to keep the VM as one single file or break it into smaller size files. Once you made your selection, click Next. On the next page, VMware displays the virtual disk file that is going to be created. It is usually located where the VM is created, but if you need, you can relocate it and select different locations to save the disk. It is best to leave it to its default values. Last page shows a summary of all the settings that you have decided. Review and click Finish. Your VM is now created. Select Edit Virtual Machine Settings, then select CD/DVD, and then select the ISO image. Click Browse and search for the Windows installation ISO file that you downloaded a few minutes ago. Now, turn on your VM. In order to boot your VM from CD, make sure to click inside your VM and once prompted, hit any key on your keyboard to boot from CD. Windows installation process will start. On the first page, select your language, time and currency, and keyboard language, then hit Next. On the next page, click on Install Now. Windows will start the setup process, but after a few minutes, shows an error message showing this PC cannot run Windows 11 and does not meet the minimum requirement. This is because Windows Need TPM V2, which is not presented in VMware. TPM, or Trusted Platform Module, is a chip on physical computers to keep security data such as fingerprints and biometrics data. To bypass this limitation, shut down your VM and completely close VMware. Open your File Explorer and go to the location where the VM is installed. Search for the file with VMX extension. Right-click on the file and open it with Notepad. Scroll to the end of the file and add this value. managedvm.autoaddvtpm equal quotes software quote. I've pasted this value in the description as well. Save and close the file. Now reopen your VMware workstation. Select the VM and click Edit Virtual Machine Settings. In the settings, you can now see a new option called Trusted Platform Module is added and is present. Click OK and turn on the VM. Follow the Windows installation steps. As you can see, this time Windows does not show the error message and will continue the setup. Continue the setup by accepting the license agreement and clicking Next. On the next page, select Custom Install. Select the hard drive and Next. Windows will start the installation process. Depending on your computer speed, this might take several minutes and your virtual machine will restart twice. After the second restart, select your country and click Yes. On the next page, select the keyboard layout that you would like to use and click Yes. Next page, select I don't have internet. On the next page, select Continue with limited setup. This is because we selected host-only network and did not allow our computer to have access to the internet. On the next page, type in the username that is using the machine and click Next. Select the password and hit Next. In this demo, I will not set a password for my lab virtual machine. You can always add a password after the setup is complete. Review the privacy settings and click Next. All the settings in this page are optional, and if you like, you can turn them all off. By clicking Next, Windows will finalize the installation. Depending on your computer speed, this might take a few minutes. Lastly, once your VM is loaded, install VMware Tools. This is similar to installing drivers. To install VMware Tools, from the VM menu, select VMware Tools. This will insert the VMware Tools CD in your virtual machine. Open Computer Browser in your VM and browse to CD drive. Double-click VMware Tools and start the installation. On the first page, select Complete and hit Next and Install. You will notice that the display size will change and the VM will automatically size the display to fit your window. After the installation, restart the VM. Congratulations! If you have been following along, you have successfully installed Windows 11 2022 H2 on VMware Workstation Pro. If you have enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel for more videos like this. You can leave a comment in the comment section down below and let me know what other subjects would you like to see. Thank you for watching and see you on the next video.